Let's draw the graph for y equals 3/4 x. So we're going to do this two ways. First, we're going to put values in for x here and find y. Then we can graph those points on our graph here and get the line for y equals 3/4 x. We'll also look at slope-intercept formula to help us do that. So let's start out by putting values in for x that we think are going to end up on our graph and give us whole numbers. So how about 0? If x is 0, 3/4 times 0, that's just 0. So that's our first point. I'd like to have whole numbers for this graph here. So I think what I'll do is I'll have x as 4, because 3/4 times 4, that just gives me 3. That'll be easier to plot. And how about negative 4? If I put negative 4 in for x, 3/4 times negative 4, that gives me negative 3. So these are the plots that will point. We could put any numbers in for x and they'll be on that line, y equals 3/4 x. But I wanted to choose numbers that would fit on my graph and would give me whole numbers. So now we can do the graph. X is 0, y is 0. That's right here. How about x is 4, y is 3? So we go over to 4, and then for y we go up 3. And you could draw the graph with 2 points, but it's better to have 3 in case you made any errors there. So negative 4 and negative 3. Negative 4x, negative 3y, and you can see they all line up. Let's put a line through them. Put arrows to show that this goes to infinity. So that's the graph for y equals 3/4 x. Let's check our work with slope-intercept formula. So we have y equals mx plus b. We have our m and our x, but we don't have a b. That just means it's 0. So for where we cross the y-axis, it's going to be at 0, right there. So that makes sense. Now we could look at the slope, m, as rise over run. So we rise 3, we run 4. Go to that y-intercept, we rise 1, 2, 3, go over 1, 2, 3, 4. Do it again from this point, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. And these are all on our line here, so we know we did this first part correctly. This is Dr. B with the graph for y equals 3/4 x. Thanks for watching.